Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum. Please welcome Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum. No, what are you looking up?
They love you. They're very excited you're here. It's a relief from me. They're very, very pleased you're here, as I am too.
I'm pleased also.
I'm very pleased to see that you're alive.
Thank you very much.
Because there was rumors on the internet that you were not alive.
Yeah. Now, how did you hear about it? Did you hear about it while it was going on, or... Or since the fact? You didn't
know. I, in fact, contrary to all popular belief, know what the internet is. And saw in the eyes like Jeff Goldblum tragically dead. I'm like, no!
You did really? No.
No. I heard about it after they said someone thought Jeff Goldblum was dead, but he's alive. I'm like, whoa, that was a roller coaster you took me on, I said.
But just for a second, they
just
told you as soon as they told. Well, there were people for a few hours. It was reported somebody started this hoax, but indiscernibly, as far as some real news organizations were concerned, and they printed it. So if you went on the internet for a few hours,
right.
It said that I had died.
That must have been awful for you.
What's it like
beyond the grave, Jeff? Is everything okay?
Yes.
Good.
It reminded me, it was a wild day. It was a wild few hours.
That happened to Sinbad as well, you know.
I didn't hear that. I heard a couple other things, but it happened to Sinbad?
Sinbad, yeah, the comedian Sinbad.
What happened to Sinbad?
Well, they reported he died. It was a couple of years ago. He's fine.
But he's fine.
Yeah, he's fine. He had a couple of rough gigs, but I would hardly call it. No, he's fine.
Well, it's wild. Well, we're all going to die, certainly.
That's a cheery thought.
Yeah, sorry. And we don't know when it's going to be fleeting. But this was a rare opportunity to sort of experience your own.
Did people say nice things about you?
Yes, some nice, some not. But I ran into people who said, and they still run into me on the street, and they say, glad to see that you're alive. Isn't that funny? But people can't, you know, I reconnected with people who I hadn't talked to for a long time in my phone book, you know,
after years.
Who, me angry?
Yes, because they only get in touch when they find out you're dead.
I wasn't angry.
You're not an angry man, are you?
I can be angry here and there, but often not. No.
You strike me as being a very balanced individual, someone who's quite happy and at ease with themselves.
You know, I think that's true.
Yeah? How would one go about doing that then?
You what?
I would quite like to be happy and at ease with myself.
Aren't you? I mean, I'm not, you know, maybe the ideal. I aspire to more... More
huh? I don't know. I don't know if I could have more.
More something. But where do you rank? You're doing fine, aren't you?
I'm a panicky, overweight comedian. I am not.
Now, you've referred to your weight, but I noticed that since I've seen you, you seem lighter. You've lost weight.
I have,
You look fantastic.
Thanks very much. Yeah, you know how I did it?
How?
I ate less.
Is that true? Is that really
the only way? Really the
what
only
you
way.
Ate had nothing to do with you? You
didn't change. Well, I ate less crap and I ate less good stuff too. I just ate less.
Portion control. That's right. Yeah. That's right. I had to do that for a movie. I had to lose 15, 20 pounds for
a
movie.
Let's not pick a fat on you.
Well, I'm still a little. I was up a little, but I'm still down from this movie that I had to play a concentration camp survivor. So I lost 15 or 20 pounds, and I had always been sort of particular about what I ate. I kind of like to experiment, but this is the first time I really exercised portion control like that. You're not eating when you're hungry.
Yes, it's very
like good. Most of the planet does. You know, most of the planet doesn't have food, of course.
Yeah,
you know, so we do it as an experiment or some artful little project, but it was It's something.
Yeah, you
if
bet.
If you want to eat, you want to eat.
And then
it's hard not to eat.
What do you like?
And
to
then
eat?
Exercise, you know. But you must exercise too.
I sometimes exercise.
What do you do? And look at your
teeth. Look at my blisters.
Now, what's that really from?
Drumming.
What's that really from?
Drumming.
Drumming.
Drumming. Yeah, I like to drum. Do you like to drum?
I love to drum. I'm a pianist. I play piano.
Well, you
as
don't
want to
hit the piano with drumsticks. It ruins the piano.
That's correct.
You're quite an accomplished pianist, aren't you?
It's a hobby for me, and I'm a humble student, but I love to do it. And I have a jazz group here in L.A.
Wow.
And in fact, in the next couple of weeks, I'll be playing a place or two, and I'll get in touch with you, and you can, if you want to, you
I can
come
do
down.
Jazz.
But you can come and see it. You can come and watch it.
No. You misunderstand me, Jeff. I can't do jazz in any form.
Do it. You can't listen to it. You don't like it.
It's a little like math to me.
Really? Well, I understand about the math because I'm not so mathy.
I would think you'd be quite mathy. You have spectacles.
Thank you. No. I made good grades in school, but no, I'm not mathy.
Really?
No, I'm very happy not to think of numbers these days. Yeah. You know,
what
no.
do you think of if you're relaxed? If you're just relaxing, thinking, well, I don't want to watch television, and I'm not going to exercise or use portion control. I'm just going to relax and have a think. What do you think about?
Well, piano. You know, I play piano music. I do like.
Yeah.
I can't believe you don't like jazz.
Well, I do like some jazz. I tell you what, I don't like is I don't
it's
like
very
the,
different. Jazz.
I know. It's such a wide spectrum.
Very different. Yeah. What don't you like? You don't like the progressive.
The very complicated.
Complicated. Yes. Lots of notes, and it goes on forever.
And then people clapping when someone plays a solo. That I find that very irritating.
Really?
Well, he's like the clarinet goes. And then he goes, oh, that's very clever. And you go, yeah, he's a clarinet player. It's his job, you know.
Very interesting.
It's the whole thing. And then the little turtlenecks and the, you know. That's not part of it?
Not obligatory. Right. No.
I thought you had to wear a turtleneck.
Don't have to. No.
I quite like the Dixieland jazz.
Ah.
Yes.
Ah. Well, I just saw. I love many kinds of jazz. Yes. I mean, it's kind of in me. From when I was a kid, I took piano lessons and classical. You know, they teach you with classical and exercises and things. And then I was sort of, which is a little more like math or a little bit more like technique or something. And I had a facility for it, but not so much an appetite for it.
Right.
But I realized I was really musical when they gave me a couple of pieces to play that were jazzy, that had that jazzy sound. I think they first gave me Alley Cat, you know, da 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 da. And when I
see, I like that.
Yes.
That was good.
And that's syncopation. Da 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 da. And it swings. You like that swinging?
Oh, I swing.
Well, so you may like jazz.
So when do we get to the swinging? I like the swinging.
Well, that's before, but it always comes back around. There's always lots of swinging.
We're completely out of time, Jeff.
No.
Yeah. Yeah.
I grieve.
Me too. I don't know if I like sexy jazz Jeff more than mathematical Jeff or not. I can't tell. By the way, your eyes are almost exactly the same prescription as mine. Did you know?
Is that true? What do you mean? You mean you wear glass corrective, which you're not wearing right now?
I'm not wearing them right now.
So things are a little blurry to you. Exactly like they are me. And do you see, like I do, I see close up, your hands are perfectly clear now, but that snake thing is a little blurry.
That's not a snake thing. Oh, yeah, that snake
yes,
thing.
It
yeah.
Yes, it is. Yeah. So this is correct. So you have that.
I do, yeah, I've got that too, yeah. We should hang out and be buddies.
Let's, please.
Yeah, all right.
We said we were going to.
And
we must.
We never did.
We should. I'm sorry for that.
Well, I'll come see your jazz.
I'll call you and tell you about the jazz, and then we'll do many other things.
Okay, nice.
Please.
Jeff Goldblum, everybody. We'll be right back. That girl looks like an enthusiastic producer. Where'd I get me a little spud like that? Please welcome the American treasure that is Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum.
Cash. Yeah, pictures.
Well, let's just see how well you do first. All right.
I don't know this one.
Yeah, it's funny. You got the eye for the cash, though. You went straight to it.
My eye fell on everything, not only the cash. Oh, you've got your nice hand sanitizer.
Yeah, well, you need some of that?
Oh, who doesn't? Always, you know.
What lovely hands you have.
You really? You think
yes,
so?
Yes, I do.
What do you like about them?
Well, I can see here that you enjoy... you enjoy your own company. It was a joke. Yeah.
Now what do you do?
Take it away. Take it away.
Oh, you put a lot on. That's enough for a whole body rub.
Yeah.
Hey.
I can't. Your eyesight's pretty.
No, I'm not. -250. -250.
I do freeze frame high fives.
Do you know this one? Did you ever learn anything like this? You know, there are two lips. No. Together. All kinds together. And they.
Oh, get out of here.
You know that. You know those.
No, I don't actually.
Oh, that feels good. What does it smell like?
Wait, alcohol. Come. Yeah. Does.
Yeah, but I bet. Isn't there a hint of lemon there? Is there something
citrusy? You go for the lemon, I'm going for the alcohol. Listen, how have you been? I haven't seen you forever.
Very well. You look good. Your teeth are sparkling. Wow, those are sparklers. Look at that. No, look. They're very. Yeah, I don't want to embarrass you, but they. Sweet.
No, you've got pretty nice teeth, too. Are they real?
Thank you. Yeah.
Mine aren't, you see.
Is that true? Or what do you got?
Well, some are real, some are imported.
True or false? Here's the game. True or false?
All right.
I've never had a cavity or a filling.
True.
Correct. That's correct.
Really?
Yeah.
What's your dental secret, Jeff?
Just freakish.
Strange, it's not something I think about you at all. I'm kidding.
He says sarcastically.
Come on.
What's that mean? You think I'm freaky?
No, I think you're a little off the beaten path, and I like that.
Thank you. You as
know,
well.
You march to the beat of your own accordion.
I bought an accordion once in Yugoslavia. True or false?
True.
Also true.
Hey,
yes.
How about that?
Very good.
All right.
Somebody wants to ask me. I went into a 7-Eleven. Somebody says, "Oh, Jeff Goldblum, here. So will you sign my bill?" And they had like a 5 or a 10. And I was like, "Oh, that's so nice. Thank you." They said, "Oh, wait a minute. Here's a 1." I got downgraded.
But you know, Jeff, it's illegal to deface the currency. You can't sign money. True or false?
I guess that's true, but when's the last time somebody was really prosecuted and for that kind of thing? Are they really going to pick you up for that? If a cop finds a bill in your billfold and you've signed it, come on, you're not going anyplace.
I don't know, man. They're pretty strict about writing on money these days.
I think it's the same as cutting tags off mattresses. You're not.
You don't do that, do you? That's dangerous. Do you sometimes eat the little packet of poison they put in the furniture as well?
What packet of poison?
No, when they put a little packet of poison, they don't eat this. When you get the furniture, don't eat this thing. They put a little thing you never seen that?
You're dreaming. Wake up. You're talking in your sleep. You're not making any sense.
And you were there. How have things been with you? I don't know where you've been. I don't know what you've been up to. Where have you been? Yugoslavia?
No.
True or false?
False. That was many, many years ago. I've just been London. London ways.
Really?
Yeah. I did a... That's why you're the best. You have real curiosity.
I'm interested. I'm interested.
I love you for that. That's wonderful. I went to. I was doing a play there on the West End.
What was it called?
The Prisoner of Second Avenue by Neil Simon. Do you know it?
Oh, I know Neil Simon. He wrote The Odd Couple, which I'm trying to adapt for a Dalek and Jeff Peterson.
Really?
Yeah.
to share an apartment, a robot skeleton and alien monster.
Yes, yes.
He's neat. He's he likes sports and he doesn't and stuff.
Oh, he's the messy one. I see. Right.
I haven't made my mind up yet.
That would be, you know, Dalek. Do people really know? I know you're educating them and you know, enlarging their horizons, but people don't know Dalek. Do you know the Dalek? Do you know the Dalek?
Yeah. Yeah.
I look at that.
Some nights the audience know the Dalek, some nights they don't.
I look at that and I see from Lost in Space, you know, Danger Will Robinson.
Little bit,
Danger
yeah, little
Will
bit
Robinson.
Like that. Yeah, he was also covered in balls. Or parts of him. But not on the show. Right. So you were in London doing a play.
I was in London
doing
a play at the Vaudeville Theatre.
I know that theatre.
You do?
Yeah, I worked in the West End myself.
You did Rocky Horror Picture Show.
I did.
Playing Brad.
How do you know this? How do you know that?
Everybody knows that. I'd like to see, can you do, you remember any of your songs or lines
no,
from
that? No, I don't remember any of it.
Bet you do.
No, I don't. Oh, man, all right then. I don't remember any of it.
What's this for? Here, you know what you do? When you tip somebody, watch this. You tip somebody, you fold it again, you do that, and then you do that. How's that look? Isn't that cool?
That looks weird, man. Why are you doing that?
Sexy.
Oh, well, okay, sexy.
It's sexy, yeah. So what are you doing? You're tipping me? Why are you giving me bills?
I'm giving you money to leave me alone. You know, like you were asking me to do stuff and sing songs, and I was like, oh, here's money. Don't ask me anything.
Really?
Yeah. You never do that to people?
No.
Do you still play the piano?
Yes, I do.
Oh, thank goodness.
You know, and you drum. We should play together. Our band is playing New Year's Eve at Cafe Was.
I'm not available New Year's Eve.
What are you doing New Year's Eve?
I'm at home. It's a big TV night for me.
Believe you, believe me, I know what you mean. I love those. I love that.
Dude, well, that's where the money is, though, doing the gigs at New Year's Eve. Do you get big money for that?
No, you're very interested in money. You're very money-oriented. No, it's not dirty or filthy.
I'm thinking of quitting the job. That's what it is.
Really?
A little bit, yeah. I've kind of had enough.
Really?
Yeah, I'm bored.
Well, people would miss you horribly. They're very lucky to have you. Before you quit, we would beg you to stay.
Well, that would be worth quitting just to get begged to stay. We have to do a commercial break. Well, we don't have to do it. We can relax. They'll show commercials. It's not like you and I have to go, hey, buy a Ford. We don't have to do that. Yeah, no. Although, it is an excellent car.
I don't know anything about cars, but I'll tell you the story when we come back about Top Gear. Do you know that show Top Gear?
Oh, I can't wait. Join us after the break. I'm just moving some stuff around here. Hold on. There you go. Now, this is Jeff Goldblum. He's here. And Jeff... Whoa.
I love the feng shui. I understand feng shui. I just did that in my bathroom. You know, I kind of redid. I did. Today, I was so foolish. But, you know, it's a pleasurable. I was taking, you know... I was taking my razor... Well... No. You can't be too clean, that's true.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Well, you've got nice hands, too, man. Look.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
What do you see there?
What? Oh, my gosh. I never noticed this tattoo.
Oh, yeah, there's a tattoo
Do
right
they
there.
Know about this?
No one never knows about that stuff. I've never mentioned it on the show before.
What is that? Have all the time? Is that what you're saying? Or
yeah, no? Yeah. I see. What's true, yeah.
Oh, I see. It's opposite.
It's a snake. It goes all the way around to my penis.
True or false?
False. It goes to here. It was.
You are uncircumcised. I know.
I am.
You mentioned earlier this week.
Yeah. No, I did. Well,
I'm not making it up. You know.
Are you circumcised? It's a perfectly legitimate question. All right. Look. Does this refresh your memory?
Yeah. You're spectacular. Anyway, there we go.
Whoa. Are you circumcised?
What do you imagine I am? What would you like? What would you like to think of me as? Take your time.
I'm going with vagina.
Very good.
No.
True or false?
No, when I start thinking of that area of a human's body, I just go, I prefer vaginas. Do you prefer vaginas?
Take that, Leno.
I'm sorry, Jeff, that was awful. Tell me about Top Gear. You're going to tell me about Top Gear.
Oh, if you want to hear, do you know that show Top Gear?
Yeah, it's a Brit. Wait. For those who don't know, Top Gear is a British show. It's on the BBC. We don't normally talk about shows on the BBC here, but Top Gear is a British show, and they review cars.
Yes.
It's a car review show.
That's right.
It's very good, I believe.
It's good. Well, it's very popular. People I was just doing that play in London, and they said, oh, they want you on this show. And I said, well, what is that show? But it gets the most viewership there in London. Mm. Anyway, they talk about cars, and I'm not really even a car person, but you compete against other celebrity types to see who can drive fastest around a track. They teach you how to race cars.
That doesn't sound bad to me at all.
It's fun. It's fun. Anyway.
Can you kill the other celebrities?
Oh, you're not on the track at the same time as the other celebrities.
I see. I'm beginning to lose interest.
All right.
No, work with it.
Okay, well, in any case, I won't bore you, but...
You've won me over. I'm back. I genuinely want to know.
Tom Cruise had been on the week before.
Okay, I'm waning again. No, I'm back. No, I'm only kidding.
It's like they do that on some shows, don't they? Have like they dial up in political speeches. We know they do, but on some shows they do too. I just did this movie, this Morning Glory show, right. And for the Today Show and those other shows, I think they have ways of reading now whether they're losing ratings from this remark to that remark, yes. to that moment, to that guest to that guest. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
In any case, I'm boring my own self.
No.
I did my race. Tom Cruise had studied very hard for it. My car that they were teaching me in the hour before I did it, died 10 minutes before I had to, go around the track. And so I had to learn an automatic.
Drive an automatic?
Years ago. Right. And then certainly never with my left hand.
Oh, yeah.
Because the thing's on the right. So I did it. But they were encouraging me. And they said, you're doing so well. Oh, this is going to be a very exciting finish.
Did he beat you?
Well, and then I go into the thing, and they interview me. They say, how do you think you did? I said, I think I did pretty good. They said, but you never got out of third gear.
Ah.
There was a fourth and fifth gear, and they'd said to me, that goes as fast as any gear. You don't have to go to fourth or fifth gear. And so I told them, I said, that's what they told me.
Yeah.
They said, no, not
Tom
true.
Tom Cruise would have gone to fifth gear.
He did.
Yeah.
Anyway, I came in well last. And for the rest of my time in London, everybody who'd seen that show said, oh, Jeff Goldblum, third gear.
Well, no one's saying that here, Jeff. We love you here.
Thank you.
To
very
me,
much.
You're always a good
guy. You're so nice. Thank you.
That's it. We're done.
No.
Oh, yeah, we're done. It's absolutely. Look, what about a little awkward pause with a harmonica?
Sweet.
Or not?
Well, you call it, whatever you say. Surprise me.
Let's do it with harmonica.
Okay.
Oh, wait, there's only one harmonica, and it's yours. I don't know where mine's gone.
What?
But here, this is for you. Oh, and it won't open. It's like a fake harmonica. Oh, no, there. Oh, there's some harmonica.
Sweet. You can drum.
I'll drum. Well.
Ooh, I like drumming. Here, do you like that? We both have drums, given the thing. Do you like, can you do this? You know, Mike Longo taught Benny Wallace this thing from Dizzy Gillespie. Here it is. Wait, listen to it. It's, what are we doing? Wait a minute. I'm D. It goes like this. Now, listen. Now watch. Now watch.
Thank you.
My first guest tonight is an Academy Award nominated actor. He's better than that. He's a good friend of the show. He's a friend of mine. He's smells lovely. Yes, I think he's here. It's that lavender smell that means Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum.
Cologne.
Yo, man wearing cologne. Oh, please, Jeff Goldblum, sit down. Lovely to see you.
Yeah.
You actually do smell very nice, Jeff. You think I don't smell at all?
No,
vampire.
They don't not smell. They don't cast an image in a mirror. You're mixing it up. Vampires don't not smell.
Well, what do they smell like then if they smell? If Mr. Vampire Expert, what do vampires smell like?
I'm not a vampire expert, but I don't think it's ever come up. I don't think vampires have that's not one of their signature, elements.
All right.
No. You smell unadorned, which I was saying I like. You smell subtle and human and fleshy.
European, you know, that's how we roll.
No, you smell clean.
Oh, I am clean, yeah. Mostly. apart from areas that are hard to reach.
Balls.
Yeah.
Balls, he says balls.
Yeah, I kind of knew, the minute we started with this, I knew he'd be in with the balls.
Really?
And, yeah.
Well, there we go.
Hey, I like your hat, Scooter.
Scooter.
Yeah, it's like
I'm
a kind of hat. Who's
Scooter?
I don't know. He's a fictional guy who's full of enthusiasm.
Oh, you're creating a this would this character would be Scooter.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I think so. I think it's a kind of like you're like a kind of copy boy in a newspaper type hat. A newspaper is like a blog.
Really?
From the olden days.
No. Is it what?
It's like a blog from the olden days.
Oh, yeah. No, I disagree. That's not what I'm going for. I mean, I may be it to you.
Well, what are you going for, then?
Well, I don't know. But copy boy would be, hello, Mr. da-da-da-da-da-da, with thing.
Okay.
And, I was going for something. And Scooter seems to be, too...
Well, let's try again. Nice hat, Lamar.
You're creative. I want to do something with you. You should...
Oh, well, do you want? Let's scratch our sides.
Yeah.
Your side's smaller than my side, but I'm allergic to French fries.
No, you're doing fine. Whatever diet you're on, what do you make? What are you grimacing for? Is that the beverage?
I'm thinking about food. I like to eat much more of it than I should.
You're doing fine. You're doing fine. Yes. Yes.
Whoa.
A little support, please. He's doing fine. You look
statuesque. I don't need patronized by the help.
You look fantastic. Why don't you look?
You look good too. I like you. I like your. You have a sort of plaid here, different plaid here, and a stripe here.
What do you think?
Well, I think gay people are going to be very upset as well. What are you doing in there with your two fingers inside your shirt? What's going on there?
Feeling my chest.
Have you got a third nipple in the middle there?
You think that?
Well, you're sitting, tinkering away at it, teasing it.
There are other things that feel nice to play with besides your nipples.
Bulls.
Well, if that's what you're doing, I'd see a doctor. They're meant to be lower.
The balls. I don't have a ball on there either. Come on.
What do you have then? Just an empty chest area?
Yes.
Do you have a hairy chest? Are you hairy?
Medium. Medium. Do you? I think a nice distribution of hair, if I say so myself. Not too, adolescent, not too prepubescent, but not too
just
bestial
right.
either.
Yeah,
just right.
Just
I'm like
right.
Baby bear.
A baby bear.
Not a baby bear, baby bear. Do you know what that means?
No.
You know what that means. You know to what I'm referring. I'm not too much, not too little, just right.
Oh, yeah, like Goldilocks and the baby bear. Yeah, that's... So do people eat their porridge off of your chest, then?
The bears eat porridge, don't they?
Yes.
Well, then if the porridge...
Yes, but you're... How would you leap? How would you make that logical leap? You're so...
You're the one that said, I'm like baby bear.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, hey.
Oh, I almost spilled my thing. That would have been tragic.
Nah, it's all right. There you go, yeah.
Your cup is so much more...
Phallic? I'm compensating. You know, I feel insecure about my penis.
Well said.
Dang. Do you feel confident about your gentleman's equipment?
Gosh.
You know, I'm like Barbara Walters, but dirtier. You know, I ask the questions. You know, I ask the questions. Here I go.
Well, go ahead. Hit me.
Are you fond of your penis?
So much, well, now that you've opened it up, I see plenty there.
I didn't open it up.
I see plenty there. It's, you know, it's...
It's a little hairier there than I'd like it to be. I won't lie to you. Yeah, but just in a line.
Well, I see... Really?
Well...
What do they call that? They call that, if it occurs lower, the...
Brazilian.
No.
Airstrip.
No. If it occurs from there downward, it means...
Happy trails?
Happy trails.
Happy trails.
Something like that.
Yeah, maybe in Georgia they call it that.
Georgia?
No, that lovely lady there's from Georgia.
That's no lady. That's a fellow. Who are you looking at?
Oh, I was looking at the blonde-haired girl. You were looking at the dude in the white shirt. Yeah, to each his own, you know.
Oh, come on. You're so sexual. You do like to bring up issues sexuale.
Yeah, I do.
It's
what makes the world go round, though.
You're right.
Are you a sexual being? You know, are you...
Quite so.
Yeah, I thought you might be.
Well, we all are, of course. We all are.
Not all of us, no. Some people are celibate. Have you ever tried that, celibacy? I did it for a couple of weeks in rehab. It's awful.
Really?
Oh,
really?
They terrible. Made you go.
Now, what does that mean? Celibacy in rehab, it means not only, no contact with anybody else, or...
Yourself.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, very nearly drank again over it.
Huh.
You ever run into a problem with drugs or alcohol? I can't imagine. You're quite a controlled person, aren't you?
You think so?
Well, not controlled, but kind of, you're not wild in that way. You're more cerebral in your wildness. Is that true?
Oh, you know, I'm a lot of funny, mixed up, you know, surprising and contradictory things.
Mm.
Gee, look how quiet it got. But, I haven't. No, I'm very, I'm very high on... You know.
Cocaine.
We have to take a break. Do you mind our conversation being interrupted by commercials?
No, I understand completely.
Good. I'm glad. I mean, we can keep talking, but this is when we can do the really rude stuff while they sell excellent products. We're right back, everybody.
Right, exactly.
Excuse me a second. Yeah. Welcome back, everybody. I'm here with Jeff Goldblum, who I never talk to normally.
We should talk more.
That very rude thing we were talking about. I'll just tell you. It's about that thing you can do with your finger.
We weren't talking about that.
No, we weren't. Like, if you want to hail a cab. Hey! Very small cab. Where do you live? You live in New York or here?
A little of both, but mostly here.
Really? I imagine you in New York. I don't know why.
Yeah, I've spent a lot of time in New York. I'm from Pittsburgh originally, and then I moved to, right after high school, New York.
Right after high school? Before college?
Yes.
Oh.
I didn't go to college.
Neither did I.
Really?
Mm. I think because I was crazy. You were crazy?
Well, I was crazy in a way. I was crazy in many ways. But I was in love with acting. Already knew, thank goodness, that I was very focused.
That's the thing you wanted to do, nothing else. Grosser? Nope, straight to acting.
Straight to acting. Yeah. And we were in, by the way, we were in the same movie, True or False?
Yes, that's right. What's
you know that? Did somebody just tell you that?
No, I remember. It was in Vancouver. It was shot in Vancouver.
Yes.
That's right.
Did. You've never seen it because no, I don't think it never came out.
Can you look it up on the internet? Yeah.
I know what it is. You want me to tell you?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's called Chain of Fools.
Chain of Fools, yes. Yes,
I looked it up today. I saw you were on that today.
Have you seen the film?
Yes, but I don't think I knew you at the time because when did we make that? Like 15 years ago?
No, about 10 years
ago or something. And I wouldn't have known.
No. And also, I only had 2 days in the film. Both days I worked with Salma Hayek and not you.
Right.
I had that written into my contract.
To not work with me or to work with Salma.
Only to work with Salma. I only wanted to work with Salma, and that was it. It was the only reason I did it. They said the 2 days with Salma, I went, all right. Very nice woman.
She's so nice.
Yeah.
She's so nice.
Very nice. Very nice woman.
She's so nice. Yeah. That was an interesting movie with Tom Wilkinson.
I worked with Tom as well.
Worked with him. He's lovely. He's wonderful,
very nice,
isn't he?
Wow. He always plays the guy who's got a bit of common sense.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Although he plays many parts. He's in so many movies. I just saw him in The Kennedys. Did you see The Kennedys?
The actual Kennedys? Or the... was it HBO?
It was not HBO. It was controversially started by HBO, and then it got onto reels. I got entertained by it. I saw all eight episodes.
Did you watch the whole thing?
I watched every moment of it, yeah.
Do you watch the Borgias?
I hate to speak publicly, but no, I've never seen the Borgias. What's the Borgias?
It's about
it's about
the Borgias. You know, they were a family in Italy, and Rodrigo Borgia became Pope, and his son Cesare was absolutely crazy. We have a clip from it. There was a clip I liked. Watch this.
He must already be pleased, Holy Father.
Oh.
That little,
I like
one.
That.
Because well, he takes his hat off and his eyebrows go up. Look
at
that again. Look,
it's too tight. The crown is too tight.
Yeah, I see.
That is very good.
Yeah.
I like the movie game. Well, I like Jeremy Irons. What else?
Jeremy Irons is very good. Yeah.
So good. What else has he been in?
Jeremy Irons.
Name a movie that he's been in.
Brightside Revisited.
Oh, well, that's a TV series,
well,
right?
TV,
but
yeah.
Then we have to name another person in that series. So let's stick to which I don't know. Do you know?
Well, Brightside Revisited? Yes, yeah. Anthony Andrews was in that.
Okay, now we have to name another movie that he's been in.
I think I'm leading you in a very bad direction.
So let's go back to Jeremy Irons and say a movie. Can you name a movie?
Die Hard with a Vengeance, mate.
No.
Yeah, he was in that.
Here, I'll tell you a movie that's good to see. I like David Lynch very much.
He was
in Inland Empire. He was also in the remake of Lolita.
Yeah, he was, yeah.
Very interesting.
I auditioned for that.
You did?
I did.
What did you audition for? For what?
Humbert.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, I love that story.
Yeah, I think everybody was just like, oh, this is, I would just be too creepy, plus a bad actor, you know. Creepy and bad acting is not the combination you want in
your movie. You would have been very good. I'd like to see you in that. No, but I love the original film, don't you?
Oh, yeah, James Mason.
James Mason.
I like the way James Mason.
Loved.
Yeah.
Lita, that's good. I love impersonations. Do you do any other impersonations?
I'm a sucker. Sean Connery, Michael Caine, and that's it.
Go ahead. Let's see. Here's a Hollywood party with Sean Connery talking to Michael Caine. It would go something like this.
Well, wait. You have to do one, too.
All right. Who would I be?
I
don't really do
Betty
anything.
White.
Betty White. You're saying that. Maybe it's subliminal, but I was just watching your highlight reel, and she's wearing a hat like this. Kind of a copy boy hat. That's right.
Yeah, that may be it.
Well, anyway.
All right, so I'm Sean Connery. You're Betty White. Oh, you know, you're sexy for someone in their 80s, Betty.
Very good. You're pretty good.
All right, yeah. Do you do anyone at all?
No, I don't do impersonations. Yeah, I used to do. Who's this? Who's that?
I don't know. It's good. No. I like it a lot. Who is it?
James Cagney. Here's somebody's mouth. I do somebody's mouth.
Oh, really?
Wait a minute. I did a line. Wait, I did.
Oh, yeah, yeah. All right. Wait. Hang on. I'll just play some music while we wait.
Okay. All right, here's their mouth.
Don't know.
Roseanne Arquette.
Let me see it again.
It's oblique. It's oblique.
It's downright crikey. Obtuse, if you ask me.
Anyway, we're done here. Don't say it. No, I have to.
You're killing me.
No, I'm not. I'm just talking to you. It just feels like I'm killing you, but I'm only talking.
Do you fancy an awkward pause or a mouth organ?
Do you have something different?
Something different. Think of something different or suggest something that we can do. We can do so many things.
What about guess what I'm thinking? What, right?
Something having to do with sex or...
No. I haven't started thinking it yet.
Really?
All right. Are you ready?
You have to guess. Yes.
All right. You ready?
Yes.
Hold on.
Jeff, you know me. I'm Rosanna Arquette.
Yes! That's Rosanna! Jeff Goldblum, everybody!
When you're not here, things get a little raw. Imagine Jimmy Page having breakfast.
My first guest tonight is a fantastic actor, very tall and very convincing in many of the roles he plays. Except when he plays short people, then is unbelievable in any way. He's starring in a seminar at the Amundsen Theatre in Los Angeles through November the 18th. The lovely Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum. You look great.
No. That was my
Jeff, don't.
No,
that was your questions. Hey, so you bought a house?
No, you bought a house.
No, I was just saying that. It's like a kind of talk show thing. People say, hey, oh, you bought a house?
I never heard that when I thought it was, how was your summer?
How was your summer?
That was okay.
All right, great.
But you did buy a house.
No, I didn't.
You didn't? I thought you did. No, but you moved. Never mind.
We moved from the old studio to this studio.
Yes. I love this. This is my first time seeing this.
Yeah,
studio.
It's pretty good. Look at the mantelpiece up there. Look at that. It's beautiful. We got a picture of Betty White, Tom, God rest, Justin Bieber, Paul McCartney.
Love that.
Yeah, no, love, a whole bunch of things. We got an autographed Pat Sajak.
Pat Sajak, which brings to mind, of course, Martin Short. Wasn't that the object of his affection or was it the I do?
What did you just do there with your leg?
I was trying to remember.
Is that how you remember things?
Possibly. I don't know.
Is that like a technique? Did you learn it from Tony Robbins or something?
No, I didn't learn it.
You didn't learn it from Tony Robbins?
No.
I can't understand your accent.
Tony Robbins, which brings us to what movie was he in? Shallow Hal. Was he in another movie? Oh, you don't remember him, Shallow Hal? He's the one who sets it all up. Remember Jack Black?
Oh, yeah.
And he meets Tony Robbins. Yes, tell me something. He goes, da-da-da-da-da-da. But wasn't he in another movie, Tony Robbins?
I don't know. Let's discuss the movies of Tony Robbins.
Well, I like the movie game. We were just playing backstage. So you go, Tony Robbins takes us to Shallow Hal, takes us to Jack Black. Now you have to name another Jack Black movie.
Kung Fu Panda.
Who else was in Kung Fu Panda?
Angelina Jolie.
Ooh, which brings us to Mr. and Mrs. Yes. For what?
Well, you heard them. Mr. and Mrs. Smart. What the hell is wrong with you?
Come on.
Mr. and Mrs. Smart.
Well, you know, and who else was in that but Brad Pitt. Which brings us to Burn After Reading. I love the Coen brothers, don't you? You like that Burn After Reading? I do, too. Francis McDormand, but you know, that brings us, you can do, if you do directors too, you go to the Coen brothers, which goes to Serious Man. Did you see that movie?
No.
I recommend it highly.
Right, good.
Highly.
We'll be right back, everybody.
In any case.
No, what are you talking about? Aren't you in a play?
I'm
we should
play.
Touch on that.
Let's touch on it at length, or at least briefly. You gave it to me, you offered it to me. I
don't know if you should drink this.
You're making up. This is another one of your theatrical improv. Imagine
a theatrical improv. How dare you?
Look at this. Wait a minute.
What?
How about this new ring? I don't believe you had this ring the last time I saw you.
I did. I just don't wear it on my finger often.
I don't know what that means.
Say things that sound like they're dirty, and people's dirty minds do the rest.
I see. I see. In any case,
what?
Very nice, very nice, very clean. You could be a dental hygienist. I can imagine you cleaning my teeth with those. Although,
well, let me have a look at you.
These days, they put on the gloves,
Let me see. Oh, I don't need to clean those suckers.
No, they're good, aren't they?
Did you just have them done?
No, I'm due for my every 3 months.
Every three months?
I like every 3 months. Do you?
Sure. Yeah. I gotta be honest, they say to me every 3 months to get my teeth cleaned, but I don't go every 3 months because I find that dental hygienists are a bit rough.
You have to get the right one. Even though every time I go, it seems I get a different one. You know. But you do have to get the right one. Sometimes they can be rough. They start with that banana,
I'm going to your one. They give you a banana?
I guess you say something and people fill in their own dirty things.
I meant a banana.
Oh, you've got fruit.
I've got fruit. I don't think I've got any
bring
bananas.
Bring that up because I see a... Is that a star fruit? What is that? What is this? You always get this in the hotel fruit basket, but this is...
Don't say hotel fruit basket like everyone gets them. Not everyone's a movie actor.
Of course.
You hate it when they give you the fruit basket with the fruit that you don't know what's in it? Come on, man!
No, come on. I'm no fancy pants type. Even if you go to the Marriott, you know, the Courtyard Marriott, don't they give you the fruit?
Courtyard Marriott? That's a swanky hotel to many Americans.
Forget it. All right.
Hey, look at this, though. Tiny little pineapple.
Wait a second.
Yeah. Perspective, baby. Who's the Whopper now? Yeah?
That's funny. This is like a bonsai, you know. But now, why in the hell do you have pineapple written on the bottom of it? Does anybody need to know that's a pineapple? Well, who's that
for? Are you sure that's a pineapple? Well, yeah, it's a pineapple, yeah.
Who's that for? Now, this, I do need a little help. Oh, I said, am I right? Star fruit.
Yeah, what? It says star fruit. You win the prize.
All right, good, good. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I like
that. It's almost like you've got a boring fruit basket out of the show.
I like that game. Show me another fruit and I'll tell you what it is.
All right, then. No, you have to guess by fingering it with your eyes closed.
I like that game.
All right, you ready?
That reminds me, when I was in France, you know they have a game like that. A lady comes out with a blindfold and there are three or it's either...
I did that on that show. Artur, that's Artur's show, isn't it? Artur Esbag, that's his show. I did it. They brought out...
You did?
Yeah, and they make you eat frogs.
No, I don't know what that is.
He said it was a show.
But either your girlfriend or your boyfriend is kind of naked to their, you know, panties, and you have to go, and you got a blindfold, and they feel two people that aren't your mates, and then you have to go, oh, that's my girlfriend or that's my boyfriend. That's an interesting show, isn't it? Isn't that what you were talking about?
Is this a real thing?
Well, that's what you were going to do with the thing.
So... And then we got to talk about your playing.
Okay.
All right. You have to guess what kind of fruit this is by touching it.
Because you know what I like best about games? Not cheating.
Okay.
Really, I do.
All right.
Just a second. Oh, wait a minute. You know what this feels like?
What does it feel
what
like?
What the hell is the name of that thing? Wait a minute. It's my favorite fruit because if you scoop it, this is a ripe one too. So much fruit depends on whether it's ripe. You know, you can get a pear. You can't get a ripe pear these days. Have you noticed?
I took the label off if that's what you're looking for.
I'm not looking at it. It's not called a persimmon. Wait a minute. It's Mexican, and it's inside, it's a kind of a white kind of, if you do it open, it's white, and it tastes like vanilla pudding.
Cherimoya?
I should have known that name. Yeah. It is exactly, I highly recommend that.
Yeah, no.
Should I throw it out of there? That's a cherimoya.
Don't injure the lesbians from England. They're notoriously litigious. Now, listen, quickly.
Okay, let's get to this.
All right, the play, yeah.
It's called Seminar.
Great. We'll be right back with Jeff Goldblum, everybody. We'll be right back. I offer people fruit at the end of the interviews, though. It's my new thing. It seems friendly.
I love it. Nice
welcome back, everybody. We were having a deep conversation with Jeff Goldblum about the play that he's in. What's it called again?
Seminar.
Yeah.
Is it about a seminar, perhaps, that Tony Robbins is at or something?
Forget Tony Robbins. It has nothing to do with Tony Robbins. No, it's a brilliant play by Teresa Riebeck, the brilliant writer who created Smash on television, but a lot of wonderful other plays that people have enjoyed and admired through the years. It was directed by the great Sam Gold. It was on Broadway. I did it there a little bit. We're opening it here with a whole new cast. Aya Cash and Lucas Nierverbrugge. And Jennifer...
I love Lucas Nierverbrugge.
You do?
Yeah. He's the Cherimoya of actors.
What kind of fruit would you be if you were a fruit?
If I was a fruit, I would be a banana, obviously.
I guess so. One of the tiny ones, like the pineapple, like the bonsai tiny one. No, a huge one. I'm sure a huge one.
No, just a regular-sized banana leans a bit to the left.
And Greg Keller is in it, and Jennifer Aikida. A fabulous,
I love her furniture.
The Aikida furniture. That's the other. This is another Aikida.
Okay.
In any case, it's a wonderful play. We previewed. We started last Wednesday, and we're doing it 8 times a week. We open officially this Wednesday.
And what's it about, though, Jeff? What's it
here's
about?
It's a boat. It's a boat. It's a boat. I love that accent, in fact.
What accent are we talking about?
The Hootman. It's about a class once a week in this lady's apartment, an Upper West Side apartment, New York. And I teach novel writing, fiction writing. I'm a creative writing teacher. And these are two guys and two gals who want to be serious novel writers. So I give them a kind of group therapy.
Did you get naked in this?
Well, I have sex with the two ladies.
At the same time?
No.
Come on, man.
I don't want to give it away. Come on, man. What?
Well, it's not a play unless you do that.
I love this place. We were talking about this place. I love it, in fact.
You have to go. I'm sorry, Jeff. You took a long time doing the fruit thing, and now we're done. We're out of time.
This is the most fun I've ever had in my whole life. True or false?
Definitely false. I've got you one thing to take on your way. It's just this little thing. If you can guess what it is, you can hold it in your hand.
Okay. Don't give it.
You can hold it in your hand.
Oh, you know what this is?
What is it?
This brings me back to my childhood.
Oh God, it's a crab apple. Jeff Goldblum, everybody.
No, love,
love,
man.
Just love, Ben.
Love. Take your labels and your classifications and, take them somewhere else. They're not welcome here. Yeah.
Yeah. That's right. If a late-night douche wants to have sex with a robot, that's fine.
That's fine.
Hey, I never said that.
What the hell, man?
My first guest tonight is a terrific actor. He's a good friend of this show. He's lovely. He's quite tall, and he smells like... What does he smell like?
Lavender.
Lavender, yeah. Really a delightful human being. Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum.
Away. We don't need anything like that.
Hey, Jeff. Girl, you're looking great.
Hey, thanks, girl. Did you call me girl?
Yeah, why not? It's just an expression. No labels, man. It's all love.
You look fantastic. Yourself. Look at you. That tie. It's so shiny. And that's the color of the... that's turquoise, right? We call it turquoise.
Yeah, yeah. That's the color of Arizona.
Oh, really?
No, New Mexico. New Mexico.
Possibly, but the color of the water in the Caribbean, too.
Jump in, take a swim, Jeff. How are you, man?
I'm very,
very good. You look great. What have you been doing?
You think so? I do. Thank you so much.
Some kind of massage thing or Pilates or something?
Massage. You put the accent on the first syllable. We say, over here, we say massage, but you say massage.
Yes.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well... I like to get the big bit done early. I like to get the mass over with and then enjoy the age.
You're so clever.
Oh, no, stop it.
You look fantastic. Look at you. Oh, nothing wrong. Look at that. I'm not looking at your...
You were looking exactly right at my jaw.
No. Well, you've put it on display for me. Look,
I didn't put it on display.
Oh, come on.
I'm wearing...
Hey, did you see these nice striped socks?
They're actually not socks. They're tights.
I don't believe that. I'd say they end about right. I'm only guessing. I'd say about right. Not grandpa style.
No,
there.
Here.
I don't believe it. With a nice garter.
Yeah,
nice garter.
That's right, yeah.
You
all right, you're creeping me out. You win. All right.
I am not. Yeah. Hey, how about your no belt? You like that Sansibelt 60s kind of, yeah. Oh, I'm glad I asked. I didn't see that.
Yeah, yeah, suspenders.
Are you, is that what you normally, are you, you
it's a thing that I picked up from Larry King.
Is that true?
No, yeah, a little bit.
Really?
I watched Larry a couple of nights on the show, and I watched how excellently his pants hung.
I don't believe that. No.
I just like suspenders.
No, his pants kind of come up.
Larry's an older gentleman, you know.
He's delightful, absolutely delightful. He likes those jeans. I think his trademark is the jean with the...
Jeans.
But never the white suspender.
Well, he's not as virtuous as I am.
You're so quick and clever. Tell me everything.
Well, okay. How about... how are things in your love life? What's going on?
Good question. Very personal. Usually I'm very discreet about my...
Well, you don't have to answer it.
Oh, so I should just think about how are things in my love life?
Yeah, how are they? I'm asking you.
They're delightful. They're delightful, actually.
Okay.
I'm deeply in love with a delightful, delightful woman.
Oh, a woman, you say?
You scallywag, you're a rascal. You're a rascal.
I don't know why I
did
that.
You're always flirting around the edges of man-on-man love.
Hey, you know what? So are you.
Me?
Yeah.
You've got
a little bit of the camp thing going on as well. You're a little bit kind of... When you hugged me there was a little bit of downstairs, hey, baby. Yeah, it was.
Not true. Yeah. What do you mean, downstairs, hey, baby?
Yeah, a little bit.
You didn't, as if you felt something?
Yeah, I felt something. Okay, I'm not afraid to admit it. I felt a little bit vulnerable and kind of excited. Yeah.
Well, that's you. That's nothing that was coming from
you. Oh, no, something was coming from you that started it all off.
I don't believe so.
I'm kidding. No, all I'm saying is no labels, man. Love. Love all the people.
Yeah,
whatever
man.
You want. It's cool.
I believe so.
I'm happy.
You are?
Sorta. Yeah. I'm clean, though.
Well, me too. Well, what does the hippie doesn't mean necessarily that you're unclean or unstraight, in the druggy sense. In the druggy sense. Speaking of which, smoking, all that interests me terrifically. Health is my credo. Yes.
Well, you do look very healthy.
I like the good health.
Do you do bending and stretching and stuff?
A little bit of that. Do
what
you?
Kind of
obviously.
You do. I do a little. I do boxing. I've got into boxing now.
Is that true?
Yes. I really
That's
like it.
Fascinating. You must have a trainer.
I do. Yes. And
so, what do you do? And how
I avoid
do you
his
do
punches
it?
Is what I do.
Well, that's what you need to do.
Yeah, yeah.
That's. I like the art of. That's a wonderful
art. It's a beautiful
art.
Science. The sweet science they call it. Isn't
sweet,
it?
Sweet science. Mm-hmm. Marcus of Queensberry. And so. But I'll bet you're good. You're tall.
I'm not good, but I'm angry and a little overweight. So that helps.
So your punches have bad intentions, they used to say.
Well, I've never thrown a punch that I meant to tickle someone, you know what I mean?
Right, right.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
So what
and
do
so
you
it keeps
do?
You in good shape. I mean, you know, I'm a regular with my discreet eating, my discriminating eating.
Well, it's all diet.
A lot of it is diet. Yes, it certainly is. And then, you know, I like to stay active. I'm always physically...
Jazz hands? You do jazz hands?
Not really. But I get up. I'm very disciplined. I go to, you know, whatever I do. I go to the gym. I do a little cardio, a little weight.
See, that's good. Yeah, mix it up. Shock the body. You got to shock the body.
That's what they say.
That's what they say.
That's correct.
That's
you do that?
Well, I've shocked a few bodies in my time, yeah. No, I find as I get older, I care less and less about respectability, Jeff. How about you?
I love that. I think that's great. I mean, respectability just in the conventional, sense.
It's like, oh, well, good for you. Everyone's calm.
Uh-oh. No. You're right. You're right. Free spiritedness
free,
is
be
mine.
Free.
I love that.
And that's why I'm on CBS, the free network.
Well, you're fantastic. Well, however, I guess they must be, because you're doing...
Oh, they just don't know I'm here. That's how I get away with this.
I don't believe so. You're prominent as all heck. And free as a bird. You're the most jazzy kind of person doing
this. You still doing the jazz?
I am. At Rockwell, you know, for the next couple of weeks, before I go off and do this play. And, I play with wonderful, wonderful guys, Zane Musa and Anthony Wilson.
Are you going to play? They're going to play with you
Elliot,
tonight.
Tim Emmons, yes.
Now, you're going to play jazz? Are.
We're going to play a little so-called jazz.
I have a problem with jazz.
We've talked about that.
I don't care for it.
But, I'd urge you away from that prejudice.
You know what? You're right, man.
Because
you're
in
right.
spirit, it's what you're talking about, and it's what you do, which is improvisation and...
I think what I don't like is I don't like hotel lobbies.
Well, you don't have to just enjoy your jazz there.
Right.
Well, the kind of jazz they play there. These guys are eighth degree black belt masters at something sophisticated and highly enjoyable, I believe.
Well, see, my problem is sometimes it feels a little, I feel like I'm a little behind the curve with it. I think that's the honest truth. When I listen to jazz, I think, I know there's something going on here, but I don't think I'm smart enough to figure out what it is. And I think jazz people kind of enjoy that, too. They kind of like, yeah, you don't know what's going on here.
Well, sometimes, you know, they're so highly skilled, and it's so particular that it can be less accessible and leave the untrained ear, a little out in the cold, because it's the most kind of, widely popular kind of thing. It's trying to speak, I believe, although there's so many kinds
of it's a very wide classification. I believe I'm being a fool when I say I don't like jazz.
Well,
I'm being a fool. I'm
so
robbing
sweet.
Myself.
Possibly so.
I think I am.
I would encourage you. Yeah,
I think I am. I'm going to change my mind.
Myself.
In fact, I love jazz, as you know.
So sweet.
It's the sign of, what is it, F. Scott Fitzgerald who said that, the sign of an excellent mind is to be able to hold two conflicting opinions at the same time.
So interesting. That's interesting. And yes, I've reread Great Gatsby recently because I saw the movie and I enjoyed that. And that thought is interesting because I'm doing this play now that I'm preparing today. I was laser focused and wildly immersed in it, and it's so interesting to me. And I'm going to do it in New York in the fall.
What's the play?
I invite you to come. It's called Domesticated. Uh-huh. Bruce Norris, who won the Pulitzer last year for Clybourne Park, and he won the Tony, wrote it. It's his new play, and it's about... divergent thoughts struggling in my one bosom.
Oh,
and
hello.
In this, you perked up when I said bosom.
Bosom. Yeah.
And conflicting ideas about what men and women are, and suggests to us wants us to consider maybe it's what we've always thought, that men are kind of boys and scallywags, and women are the soulful holders of the monogamous space, or maybe it's something else.
Oh, it's something else.
You think so?
Yeah.
Like what?
I think people are as individual as snowflakes. They kind of look alike, but no two are exactly the same. And all classification is the root of prejudice.
Beautifully put. But do you think there's anything that one can generalize about a woman in contrast to a man? We know from other species.
For the most part, they smell better. That's the only thing I could say.
Yes.
Yeah. For the most part. Although in Hollywood, it's about 50-50, man. Anyway, we got to take a break, and then you can come back and play some jazz, which, as you know, I'm a huge fan.
I'd love to. Yes, it's meant for you. I love that pocket square. Oh. I love everything about you.
We'll be right back. Cats, welcome back. If you watch this show regularly, you know I'm a huge jazz fan, right, Jeff?
I love the jazz.
I do love the jazz.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
So here performing straight... here performing straight no chesser, Jeff Goldblum and the Mildred Snitzer Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Jeff.
Get that? Yeah. You like that? Yeah.
It's a movie star. He's in two new films, The Grand Budapest Hotel, which is in theatres now, and Le Weekend, which is French for The Weekend, which is out this Friday. Take a look at this. Jeff Goldblum, everybody. Jeff Goldblum. Yeah, look at that. They're
so
crazy
nice.
About you.
Oh, they're so
they're
nice.
They're crazy about you, as am I.
You're so nice. I'm crazy about you, crazy about you.
Well, that's... You look really nice, Jeff. You look really lovely with your bow tie. It's really very, very splendid indeed. Did you? It's a tied one, too.
It's a tied one, yeah. I tied it myself.
Really?
Yeah, do you know how to do that?
I do, but I can only do it on ladies. I could try it, I suppose.
You scallywag. Hey, how'd you like that clip?
It was good. Like that was Jim Broadbent there. The great Jim Broadbent.
The great Jim Broadbent and Lindsay Duncan. They're spectacular. And Le Weekend, it may... go find it. It gets 10 gold blooms out of a possible 10 gold blooms.
Whoa, that's the best you can... do you have your own movie phone?
No.
But
it gets my highest recommendation. See it. I'm telling you, you would get a big kick out of it.
I want to see it. It's got things I like in it. It's got you. It's got Broadbent. It's got Paris. I love Paris.
It's in Paris. You were in Paris.
Many times.
I really play you in the movie. I'm a writer. Yes. Look at him perk up.
I play, and now I'm intrigued. Mm-hmm. I play a writer who goes to Paris to write a book.
I've done that.
Between the river, between the bridge and the river.
That's the book I wrote in Paris.
You liar,
pants on fire. That's not what you're doing in the book.
No, I do. I recommend that novel, by the way. Very brilliant.
Thank you.
I play a writer who gets involved with a new relationship. I have a new wife, and she's pregnant, and there's issues involved. And it's like you.
Yeah, it's kind of my, yeah.
It's you.
I might have to sue you.
Yeah, don't.
Okay.
Don't sue.
How are you otherwise?
Very well.
You must have been traveling a lot. You were at the Grand Budapest Hotel in Budapest?
We weren't in Budapest.
Oh, dear.
No. You've been in Budapest?
Yes, I have, actually, yes.
Really?
Have you? No, I never have.
Oh,
you must go.
Really?
Oh, it gets 10 gold blooms out of a possible 10 gold blooms.
That's my highest.
That's the highest
highest. We shot the Grand Budapest Hotel in Görlitz, Germany.
Ah. Where's Görlitz?
It's a wonderful place on the border of Poland.
Ah.
An untouched fantasy place. Anyway, we shot this movie that people are going crazy about and I brought this just to remind myself, and using words, because it's indescribable, it's a very beautiful movie, that I didn't know, and maybe you'll know them.
Okay.
Do you know these words? A reviewer said it's full of gorgeous furbelows. F-U-R-B-E-L-O-W.
That's the thing. Remember in Star Trek, these little things that took over the Enterprise?
Uh-huh.
Furbelows.
Those are furbelows. Possibly so. I was not familiar with that. Now I'll look it up, since nobody knows it. You don't know it?
No.
Okay,
no.
There we go.
Come on.
They're smart.
No, half of these people don't speak English.
And the other one, they said it's a storybook, samizdat. S-A-M-I-Z-D-A-T.
Oh,
I'd never heard of that word.
It's a word which I often use in conjunction with Weltanschauung.
Weltanschauung. Yeah. You Jerry, yeah.
No. Anyway. I don't. The only German word I use with any regularity is Schadenfreude.
Schadenfreude.
Yeah.
Ah, yeah. Schadenfreude means
delighting in the misfortune of others.
Yeah, misfortune of others. Schadenfreude.
Only the Germans would have a word for it. Oh, it's so good. Let's have a word for it.
Yeah.
Schadenfreude.
Yeah. But that's a bit of evil that we sometimes indulge in, you know.
I'm quite evil.
I am too.
Yeah, I know.
We have to. It's struggle. You have to find joy in other people's
fortune. You have to fight the Schadenfreude
within. You have to fight the Schadenfreude.
Yes, absolutely.
That's right. Hey, you know, I was looking at our last conversation the last time I was here. And I was stricken with vain grief and recrimination. I was looking, HDTV, you know. I hadn't realized until just before I came here, I saw it.
Mm-hmm.
I was drooling during the first bit of, I had some spittle on my chin during the first few minutes of that conversation.
Well, had you been enjoying a snack before you came out or something? Did you have some kind of viral infection?
Certainly not, no. It was your delectability. And you're my appetite from being around you, I'm sure.
Well, I've never had such a lot of furbelow in my life.
There you go. That's how we'll learn it. We'll
just start using it.
We'll start using it.
Yeah, yeah.
However wrongly.
I've started smoking a pipe.
I see you have.
Yeah, yeah, but only with no tobacco or crack in it, and when I'm performing therapy on my guests, which I suspect you need.
I certainly do, and I'd enjoy having you as a therapist. Go ahead. Guide me.
Tell me about your love of travel. What are you trying to escape from, Jeff?
Interesting. I don't love travel so much. I like being forced to travel, having these jobs. You know.
You like being forced?
I said it, so it must be true. What's that? What kind of therapy is this? What kind of therapy is this?
It's mock therapy.
I see.
It's a sort of furbelow technique.
I see.
Well. Do you actually go to therapy? Do you get therapy?
Yeah.
Me too. I'm a big fan.
I like it. I like it a lot. These days, although I just saw my therapist yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
A wonderful woman, in fact, and she's very good. But I see her these days, not regularly, but as needed.
I see that. What? That's no good? You got to go regularly?
Yeah, well, here's the problem. As needed would imply that you would decide when you need it, which I think is not really getting the perspective of someone else helping you along, you know?
Really?
You think, oh, I think I need therapy. You probably needed it way before you thought it.
You're probably right.
Jeff, I don't want you to suffer. I think you're such a lovely man. I want to see you happy at all times.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. I am. Actually, our conversation yesterday put me at peace.
Really?
Yes, it did. Yes, it did. She's very accepting. That's what she does. I start to talk and I start to go, you know, I don't tell anybody else this.
Yes.
Won't tell anybody else this. Mm-hmm. That's a great thing about therapy. You know,
you can tell them anything you like.
Yeah. And I feel like she's, you know, non-judgmental.
Mm-hmm.
And then I found myself yesterday as I was talking going, uh-huh, so there I am. That's my situation. And, I was considering it, and I realized it was all right to have this kind of difficulty. Well,
yes,
anyway.
Absolutely.
It was nice.
Of course. we have to take a commercial break. That in no way is a judgment.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with Jeff Goldblum, everybody. We're back on the air, so don't see anything of any import now.
All right. But you're very trustworthy. You know, you would be a good therapist. You're a good friend, and I feel like I can tell you.
I actually lack judgment, really, at all. I mock mercilessly, but there's no engine behind it, if you know what I mean. I don't really mean it.
I know.
You know?
You're enlightened and very wise.
I am enlightened. I am. You're right. I am a little bit. I believe in the Enlightenment. I believe in knowledge. I believe in the searching mind, a curious mind, and a sharp eye. Don't you, Jeff?
I do. I sure do. Curious mind and a sharp eye. You ever try to find an ironclad lead for yourself from a three-rail billiard shot?
Oh.
Well, just as I say, it takes judgment, brains, and maturity. To score in a Bach line game, I'd say than any boob. Now, what's that from?
A play?
Yeah, musical play. Nobody knows. Yes, that's correct.
Well, you set
me off on it.
Well, I did. Did I?
Yeah, a sharp eye, a keen hand, a cool eye. You ever take? That's how it's said. You ever take? Try to find an ironclad lead for yourself in a three-rail billiard shot.
Monorail. Well, we're out of time, Jeff.
No, I grieve. I grieve.
It's all right to grieve. That's perfectly normal.
Thank you.
Under the circumstances.
Under the circumstances?
You hold your chin a lot, I've noticed.
Not a lot.
Are you checking for a spit?
Probably subconsciously.
Yeah, I think a little bit.
I don't want to have that. I just want to keep wiping in case anything dribbles down.
Okay. awkward pause, meditation. How do you want to get out of here?
It's meditation. You know what my meditation was today?
Mm.
I do it every day. I have another name. I get through the meditation, I give myself an alternate name.
Mm-hmm.
Today, I'm not Jeff Goldblum. I am Play Sport Pure Joy.
And I am Fun Time Furbelow. Let's go.
Here we go.